melons produce excellent quality fruits when grown in sunny, hot and dry environments. In northern Australia, traditional melon fruit types like rock melon, honeydew and canary are all grown outdoors. From these warm regions, melons are supplied seasonally to domestic markets and to some export markets. Climate variability still represents a production risk, as it can reduce both yield and consistency of fruit quality. Fruits with poor visual appeal and eating quality result in unsatisfactory consumer experiences that are reflected in fewer repeated purchases. The use of protected cropping to grow specialty melons is an emerging production system in Australia. Adoption of protected cropping can assist delivering melon fruits with superior eating and visual quality to niche domestic and export markets. Here at the Queensland Department of Agriculture and Fisheries, we've been conducting melon crop evaluations using protected cropping systems for several years. A number of specialty melon types can offer consumers a variety of new flavours, textures, as well as consistently sweet product. Simple, cost-effective protected cropping technologies can provide optimum growing environmental conditions in the Australian tropics. Structures with specific agronomy practices can help deliver exceptionally sweet fruits year-round. Let's now go through the general steps in a melon soilless production system. Crops are started with seedlings grown in trays and then transplanted into plant containers with soilless media. A complete nutrient solution is delivered to the containers, adjusting volumes and nutrient solution concentrations as plants grow and fruits develop. The plants will be supported vertically to increase light use efficiency, plant population density, and fruit yield per square metre. Each plant has the main vine trellised vertically around a hanging twine. To promote the growth of the main vine, lower lateral shoots are pruned off as they appear. Then, to determine where fruits will set, a few lateral shoots will be left to grow. Female flowers will appear on these lateral shoots, while male flowers, carrying the pollen, will appear earlier along the main vine. Bees will assist with pollination that will set fruits on female flowers. 2 days after pollination, small fruits can be observed on each lateral shoot. To discourage additional vegetation and small fruits on these lateral shoots, the shoots are terminated, leaving 2 to 3 leaves near the fruit. Then the main vine is also terminated to restrict further growth. From this time, fruits grow in size, form a net on their outer surface and then mature. Because fruits were selected to set at the same location in all plants, they will mature at the same time and will be very similar in quality. If more than one fruit is allowed to set on plants, there will be greater yield with smaller sized fruits. There will also be more variability in fruit quality at harvesting time. Depending on cultivar and production season, fruits will be ready to be harvested between 65 and 85 days from transplanting. There are several fruit quality indicators that let the grower know when it's the best time to harvest. These include changes in skin colour, senescent leaves next to the fruit, and cracks appearing on the base of the fruit peduncle. During harvest, fruits are handled with care to avoid internal and external bruises. Fruits are then washed, dried, and packed in cartons and transported in cold storage. Shelf life of high-quality fruit can be more than 15 days. An effective integrated pest and disease management plan will include cultivars with genetic resistance to diseases, preventative practices, regular crop monitoring, and reliance on biological control agents. Growing specialty melons in protected cropping is a new production system in Australia and has potential opportunities in warm climate regions. These systems can increase marketable yields 2 or more times than in outdoor crops. However, the focus on protected cropping should be to achieve high fruit quality and net economic returns per square meter. The production of premium fruit quality will bring new supply opportunities for both domestic and export markets. Specialty melons must be considered a premium fresh product, and as such, differentiated and marketed to achieve the best returns. To offset the costs of protected cropping, prices and returns to the grower need to reflect the consistent higher fruit visual and eating quality. There is not one way to grow specialty melons with protected cropping. If you're interested in knowing more about specialty melons, please contact the Queensland Department of Agriculture and Fisheries. We'll be happy to assist. Research activities on specialty melons have been supported by industry, including initiatives aided by CRC for developing Northern Australia, growing Queensland's food for exports, and Hort Innovation through the Queensland Smart Farms.